Hi, Arthur. Hi.
He's so solid today.
He must have just made him talk.
Oh, I don't know.
Managed to regroup and meet adversities and triumphs head on. Our experiences have been countless. For example, I remember the time the entire class faced Mr. Salas's paddle because we acted like stooges and broke the lawn sprinkler. Another memory always returns to me, the one of Mario and Phil and their numerous sparring matches. Yeah, Mario seemed to always be in something, or should I say everything. He got stabbed by Flo. He fought with Larkin and with me. He locked himself up in the closet with Clarice. And he fell into an empty swimming pool. But it wasn't always Mario. I recall when Robert, Benji, and I got in trouble for snagging, cruising, and totally destroying Cody's bike. It was fun then, but it sure hurt when Dad found out. You're sidetracked from their lesson and keep us all distracted. We could depend on Sam to lend an ear, especially if there was a good joke around. He was always ready to have fun. Or if someone needed a ride, he was ready. No inspiration. Mr. Salas, thank you for your good advice, which I'm sure led me in the right direction. Now, on behalf of my fellow classmates and myself, I would like to extend a sincere thank you to parents, teachers, and friends who have helped us reach this stepping stone to the future. Again, welcome to everyone.
Michael Garcia is presenting to Teddy and Gloria Garcia, Mary and Jimmy Garcia, Esther Mondragon, and Jeremy Fernandez. Nando Branchal and Talpita Trujillo. Sammy and Pamela Clothier, Mrs. Tom Chavez, Pauline Romero in memory of Stella Clothier, and to Francis Armijo, Kika.
During my years in high school, I went through several different views of life. I changed my mind a lot, but I finally decided that you put into life what you get out of it. When I say life, I mean anything that you do in life. I believe this because if you do something, for example, school, and you try real hard and study, you won't have the kind of fun you have if you just mess around. But it might just be worth it when that report card comes in. It just depends on what you want out of life. So in my opinion, no matter what you do in life, you get the same enjoyment out of it. So you can either say work hard in life or relax. I've heard people say both things. I personally think that life is short, so you should work hard. In regard to that, I believe the saying, what does not kill me can only make me stronger. Because if you try hard at something and it doesn't work out, it doesn't really hurt you. All it means is that you learn from your experience and you'll be stronger for the next challenge. These views changed the way I thought. I didn't always think this way. I changed my views in the middle of my freshman year. I realized that if I was gonna get out of life what I was putting into it, I wasn't gonna get anything. So I started trying hard in whatever I did. I am thankful that I made this change, and I feel that it's been worth it. I wish to thank my teachers, and most of all, Mike Glassman. He taught me that nothing in life is free.
and that you have to work for what you get. But when you earn it, it's worth it. I also want to thank my very best friend, Michael Garcia, who taught me to have confidence and to believe in myself. And most of all, I want to thank my family, some of which traveled a long way to get here. Finally, I thank all of you here today who helped make this commencement a success. I bid you all farewell, wish you all well. Thank you.
Present the graduating class of 1997 Wagon Mound High School. His TOLD will present this. Benjamin Trujillo. Geronimo Bronshaw. I'd like to wish congratulations to the class of 97.
Sir, do you have a...
And his mother.
Oh, sweet.